नमस्कार एवरीवन, आई एम डॉक्टर पीयूष बांगड़, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर वनस्थली विद्यापीठ. द टॉपिक यूसेज ऑफ स्ट्रेडल ऑप्शन स्ट्रेटेजी माइट जनरेट यूर इंटरेस्ट व्हेन यू आर ट्रेडिंग इन स्टॉक मार्केट विद द ऑप्शंस. द स्ट्रेडल ऑप्शन स्ट्रेटेजी इज जनरली यूज टू टेक द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ द वॉलेटिलिटी ऑफ द स्टॉक मार्केट. द ऑप्शन आर टाइप ऑफ फाइनेंशियल डेरिवेटिव्स. First of all, let us understand the meaning of the financial derivatives. Definition of the derivative are, as per the Security Contract Regulation Act 1956, derivatives are the instrument which are derived from a debt instrument, share, loan, whether secured or unsecured, risk instrument or contract, for differences or any other form of the security. Also, derivatives are the contract which derive its value from the prices or the index of prices of underlying securities. Different type of derivative instruments are, number one, forward. A forward contract is a customized contract between two entities where settlement takes place on a specific date in the future at today's pre-agreed price. Futures. Second one is the futures. Future contracts are special type of forward contracts, but the future contracts are the standardized exchange traded contracts. Then third one is the options. Basically, there are the two types of options. Number one is the call, number two is the put. Call are the instrument which gives right to buy any asset, but not the obligation to buy a given quantity of the underlying asset at a given price on or before a given future date. Puts give the buyer the right but not the obligation to sell a given quantity of the underlying asset at a given price on or before a given date. The next one is the warrant. Options generally have a life of up to 1 year. The majority of options traded in option exchange having a maximum maturity of the 9 months. Longer dated options are called as warrants and are generally traded over the counter exchange. Then next is the LEAP. LEAPs are the acronym for long term equity anticipation securities. These are options having a maturity of up to 3 years. Next is the basket. Basket options are options on portfolios of underlying asset. The underlying asset is usually a moving average of a basket of asset. Equity index option are a form of basket options. Next one is the most important derivatives, and that is swaps. Swaps are private agreements between two parties to exchange cash flows in the future according to a pre-arranged formula. They can be regarded as portfolio of forward contract. The two commonly used swap are as follows. Number one, interest rate swap entail the swapping only the interest related cash flows between the parties in the same currency. Then second one is the currency swap. Currency swap entails swapping both principal and interest between the parties with the cash flows in the one direction being in a different currency than those in opposite direction. The next and last type of derivative is the swaptions. Swaptions are the options to buy or sell a swap that will become operative at the expiry of the options. Thus, a swaption is an option on the forward swap rather than have call and put. The swaption market has receiver swaption and payer swaption. A receiver swaption is an option to receive fixed and pay floating. A pair swaption is an option to pay fixed and receive floating. Then now we'll discuss some option terminologies which are generally used in the option strategies. In the option terminology, the first terminology is the index option. Now the question is, what exactly the index option? When the option have index as an underlying, for example, Nifty is the best example. When any option remain on the Nifty is known as the Nifty option. So this type of options are also known as index option. Then second one is the stock option. Stock options are options on the individual stock. The example of these type of options are Reliance, TCS and SBI option, because these are the companies which are listed in the National Stock Exchange. Hence, when any underlying asset is a stock, then the option on the stock is known as the stock option. Then buyer of the option, the buyer of an option is one who by paying the option premium and buys the right but not the obligation to exercise his option on the seller or writer. Then next is the writer or seller of an option. The writer or seller of a call or put option is the one who receives the option premium and thereby obliged to sell or buy the asset if the buyer exercises on him. Then next is the call option. A call option gives the holder the right but not the obligation to buy an asset by a certain date for a certain price. Put option. A put option gives the holder the right but not the obligation to sell any asset by a certain date for a certain price. Then option price or premium. Option price is the price where the option buyer pays the option seller. It is also referred to as the option premium. Next is the expiration date. The date specified in the option contract is known as the expiration date. Then next one is the strike price. The price specified in the option contract is known as the strike price or the exercise price. Then next one is in the money option. An in the money option is an option that would lead to a positive cash flow to the holder if it exercised immediately. A call option on the index is said to be in the money when a spot or current price stand at a level higher than the strike price. That means spot price is greater than strike price. If the index is much higher than strike price, the call is also known as deep ITM. Deep ITM means deep in the money option. In the case of a put, the put is a ITM if the index is below the strike price. Let us take an example. For example, Nifty is currently trading at 10,000. If the call of strike price having 9900, then it is known as in the money call option. But in the case of put, the strike price having the put option of 10,100, then it is known as the ITM put. At the money option is an option that would lead to a zero cash flow if it is exercised immediately. An option on the index is at the money when current index equals the strike price. Spot price is equals to strike price. The next one is the out of the money. An out of the money option is an option that would lead to a negative cash flow if it were exercised immediately. A call option on the index is out of the money when the current index stand at the level which is less than the strike price, that is spot price is smaller than strike price. If the index is much lower than strike price, the call is said to be deep OTM. In the case of a put, the put is OTM if the index is above the strike price. The next is the intrinsic value of an option. The option premium can be broken down into the two parts. Number one, intrinsic value, and second one is the time value. The intrinsic value of a call is the amount the option is ITM. If it is ITM, if the call is OTM, its intrinsic value is zero. Putting it another way, the intrinsic value of a call is maximum of zero or spot price minus strike price, which means the intrinsic value of a call is greater than zero or spot price minus strike price. Similarly, the intrinsic value of a put is maximum of zero or strike price minus spot price. That is the greater of zero or strike price minus spot price. K is the strike price and ST is the spot price. The time value of the option. The time value of an option is the difference between its premium and its intrinsic value. Both call and put have time value. An option that is OTM or ATM has only time value. Usually, the maximum time value exists when the option is ATM. The longer the time to expiration, the more the greater is an option's time value, all else equal at the expiration. An option should have no time value. The straddle strategy, there are the basically two type of straddle strategy. Number one is the long straddle. Number two is the short straddle. A long straddle is a neutral volatility strategy and it and it is used when the stock index price is expected to show a large movement. This strategy involves buying a call as well as put on the same stock index for the same maturity and the same strike price. To take the advantage of a movement in either direction, if the price of stock or index increase, the call will exercise while the put expires worthless. And if the price of the stock index decrease, the put is exercised. Call expires worthless. It is a debit strategy as the investor pays the premium to it. When to use? Now, the question is, when to use? The investor think that the underlying stock index will experience significant volatility in the near term. That means the market can move in any of the direction. It can go upside or it can come towards the downward side. Then risk is limited to the initial premium paid in this particular strategy. The next one is the reward. The reward is the unlimited in this particular strategy. Then the break even point. There will be the two break even point in this strategy. First one is the upper break even point, that is the strike price of a long call plus net premium paid. Then second break even point will come at the lower side, that is also known as lower break-even point. That means strike price of long put minus net premium paid. Then long straddle formation. How can we form to this particular strategy? Let us take an example. For example, Nifty is trading as 9980. That means 9980 in the spot market on 20th May. An investor, Mr. A, enters a long straddle by buying a June rupees 10,000 Nifty put for rupees 40 and a June rupees 10,000 Nifty call for rupees 30. The net debit taken to enter the trade is rupees 70, which is also his maximum possible loss. The upper break-even point will come at 10,070. That means 10,000, which is the strike price of call or strike price plus the net debit of the strategy. That means above 10,070, the investor will enjoy the unlimited profit above the break-even point. Then lower break-even point. Lower break-even point will come at 10,000 minus 70. That means 9930. Below 9930, the investor will enjoy the unlimited profit. That means the investor will get the unlimited profit below 9930 and above 10,070. Investor is in position of loss if the Nifty clause on expire between 9930 to 10,070. Then I have been prepared a net payoff table of the long straddle, where the first column is Nifty closing, then second column is Nifty premium, third column is payoff from the call option, fourth column is payoff of the put option, and fifth column is the addition of second column, third column and fourth column, and this column is also known as net payoff. First of all, we can see if Nifty close at 9500 on the June expiry, then what will happen? In the second column, we can see there is the premium of minus 70. That means this is the amount which we have been paid to the sellers, or buyer has been paid to the sellers. That means 30 rupees of call and 40 rupees of put has been purchased by the buyer from the seller. In the third column, we can see it is the call option payoff. At 9500, the call will not execute. Then in the column number 4, which is the payoff of the put option, the put will execute because it is below the strike price. That means at the level of 9500, the put option will generate 500 rupees profit or 500 point profit. Then in the column number 5, you can see the net payoff, which is the addition of column number 2, column number 3 and column number 4. That is the plus 430 rupees. The investor will earn 430 rupees when Nifty will be close at 9500. At 9600 level, the investor will earn the 330 rupees. At the level of 9700, the investor will earn the 230 rupees. In the same way, at the level of 10,300, the investor will earn again 230 rupees, but this time call will be executed and put will not be executed. At the level of 10,400, the profit will be of 330 rupees, and at the level of 10,500, the profit will be of 430 rupees. You can see the chart which I have been prepared. That is the V-shaped chart. On the x-axis, I have been put up the Nifty. On the x-axis, I have been put up the levels of the Nifty. And on the y-axis, I have been put up the net profit. So, the maximum net loss in this strategy, the investor will get at the level of 10,000, which is the minus 70. And above 10,000 and below the 10,000, investor will get the unlimited profit. It doesn't matter market is moving in which direction, whether it is going up or whether it is going down. Short straddle. A short straddle is the opposite of long straddle. It is a strategy to be adopted when the investor feels the market will not show much movement. He sells a call option and a put option on the same stock or index for the same maturity and strike price. It creates a net income for the investor if the stock index do not move much in the either direction. The investor retains the premium as neither the call nor the put will be exercised. However, in case the stock index moves in the either direction or upside or downside significantly, the investor losses can be significant. So, this is a risky strategy and should be adopted very carefully and only when the expected volatility in market is the limited. If the stock index value stays close to the strike price on the expiry of the contract, maximum gain, which is the premium received, is to be made in this strategy. It is a credit strategy as the investor keeps the premium with himself or herself. Then, now the question is when to use this particular strategy. The investor thinks that the underlying stock index will experience a very little volatility in the near term or the market will remain a range bound position. Then only this particular strategy can be applied. The next one is the risk. Risk is unlimited in this strategy because investor has been shorted the call as well as put option, which is very riskier position when it comes to the seller of the option. Then reward. Reward is limited to the premium received only. Then the break-even point. Again, there are the two break-even point. Upper break-even point will come at strike price of the short call plus net premium received. Then the second one is the lower break-even point, that is the strike price of the short put minus net premium received. Short straddle formation. Now we can see the short straddle formation. Let us take the previous example. Suppose Nifty is trading at 9,980 on 20th May. An investor Mr. A enters a short straddle by selling June rupees 10,000 Nifty put for rupees 40 and a June rupees 10,000 Nifty call for rupees 30. The net credit taken to enter the trade is rupees 70, which is also the maximum possible profit for the investor. Now, the break-even point in case of this example is 10,000 plus 70. 10,070 will be the break-even point. That means about 10,070 losses will be incurred. Then break-even point, which is lower, that is the 10,000 minus 70, that is 9,930. Investor is in the position of profit if the Nifty is close on the expiry between 9,930 to 10,070. Now the table number 2, which is the net payoff table of the short straddle. It is just opposite strategy to the long straddle. Now again, same 5 column have been put up. Here, first column is Nifty closing, second is the premium, third one is the payoff of the call option, then fourth column is payoff of the put option, then next is the net payoff, that is the column number 5, which is the addition of 2 plus 3 plus fourth column. For example, Nifty is closed at 9500, then the premium which he will receive, that is the 70 rupees, call will not execute at the level of 9500, but yes, output will give a loss of net 500 rupees. Why? Because you have been sold, or any investor has been sold 500 rupees. Then in the net payoff, in case of net payoff, in the last column, the investor is getting net 430 rupees loss if Nifty is closed at 9500. In the same way, at the level of 9600, he will get the loss of minus 330. At the level of 9700, he will get the loss of minus 230 rupees. In the same way, at 10,300, only call will execute, this time put will not execute, and the investor will get the loss of 230 rupees. At the level of 10,400, investor will get the loss of minus 330, and at the time of 10,500, investor will get the loss of minus 430 rupees. Here I have been putted one of the chart of the net payoff of the short straddle, which is just opposite to the long straddle. Here on axis, again the Nifty closing are there, and on y-axis profit and loss I have been putted. You can see at 10,000 level in either direction, then ultimately the investor will face the unlimited loss. Thank you for watching the video. You will enjoy the long straddle and short straddle in the live stock market. Thank you for watching once again.